he must have sort of gone to bed at night or got up in the, when he woke up in the morning, he must have thought, oh, I'm awake again, you know, this is what I do, I'm Franz Stengel, and, you know, and we've got to, we're going to kill another few thousand people.
No, not at all, really not at all. That is not how his mind, or any of their minds, would have run. It was finally a job, you know. And the matter of killing was not what is foremost, was foremost in their minds. What was foremost in their minds was to make it tidy, to prevent or to avoid any problems. To God, I mean, never these basic things, fundamental things that you think they would have been occupied with, not at all. I mean, if I sort of remembering Stengel, and to think of him as being fundamental is almost funny.
It's so strange that you find it funny.
Well, it's almost funny, you know, because here I see this, I remember this simple man who, you know, he covered his simplicity, if you like, with the fact that he was in a tidy uniform, and that the uniform has a lot to do with how they are, how they behave. It gives them a certain, it gives them more certainty than they have, you know. I mean, without the uniform, he would have been, he couldn't really have sat with me. That was, very, very important to them to be the somebody they became because of the uniform. And Stengel certainly felt this quite strongly, I think.
So this phrase, the banality of evil, is that what you're talking about?
I really dislike that sentence, but I suppose so. I mean, evil is a huge word. I mean, actually, there was nothing evil about Stengel. No, really, I know that must sound very strange, but there wasn't. He was not an evil man. He was a simple man. The fact of being involved in the, you know, in the killing of millions, which is what it was, it isn't how he saw life. You know. He saw life as being in charge of other men and of making sure that they behaved themselves, and in fact, I think probably also that they did the work as, if one can use that word, as decently as possible. Probably one can use the word. Mostly, I think, because if they hadn't done it decently, or if they didn't do it decently, they had trouble. He had trouble. You know. I mean, it was always amazing to me to realize how, well, I can't use the word readily, but how uncomplainingly these millions went to their death. I mean, it's perfectly extraordinary, isn't it? There were practically never any, well, revolt is not even the word one can use, but any sound, you know? One would have thought they would scream or yell or something. Nothing. They just went. It was like I'm not sure that, I mean, one really can't say it was a mass psychosis, because it wasn't. Was it fear? Perhaps. Was it also a realization that it wouldn't make any difference? I don't know that they were, I really don't know that, it's not the word of intelligence, you know, but I don't think they were aware enough to to think in these details.